How goes it, Griffin Nation? I'm Chris Hernandez, and it's time for another edition of On the Hill with Hernandez. I'm here to take a look at tomorrow's match between CHC Women's Volleyball and Goldey-Beacom College. And as promised, we'll take a look at the remaining schedule. These two teams faced off in their conference opener, with the Griffs losing 3-1. In that contest, the Griffins tallied the third most errors in a CAC opener in the last 5 seasons. Since that game on September 13th, CHC is 7-5 and the Lightning are 6-6 against CAC opponents. They are now both tied at 7-6 heading to tomorrow night. The player to watch on Goldey-Beacom is freshman Brianne Haley. She has a conference-leading 208 kills and registered 24 this year versus Chestnut Hill, which is tied for her second highest total in one game. A lot has changed since their last meeting. I believe CHC has become a better team, and the numbers show it, winning 4 of their last 5 CAC matches. On the other hand, Goldey-Beacom may be sliding a little bit, only winning 2 of their last 5 CAC matches. Furthermore, we've had great success with this team in the past. In our last 5 matches, we've won 4 of them. I don't think we dropped 2 in a row. The last time we lost back-to-back games versus Goldey-Beacom College was 8 years ago in 2009. Now for the fun part, here's the current standings after the weekend. Wilmington drops a game to post, so they push down. Georgian Court stays put at third after their loss to Caldwell. So like I said earlier, we're tied with Goldey in fourth. With all that in mind, let's pull up the final 5 games in 2017. The first thing I see is 3 of these games are at home. Plus, one is about 15 minutes down the road at Jefferson University, so that's still pretty local. Holy Family is always a struggle for us. We already beat Jefferson this year, so I expect the Rams to throw everything but the kitchen sink at us. Post is in the North Division, but a huge win over the Eagles can go a long way. We defeated Georgian Court in dramatic 5 sets in 2017. Only disclaimer, we've never won at Georgian Court. Wilmington falls on Senior Day, so there's some extra incentive in that game. All of these games are of importance from here on out. We have the power to control our own destiny. It won't be easy, and we'll have to earn it, but everything is out in front of us. That's all for today. Thanks for spending some time with me on the Hill. I'm Chris Hernandez, and I'll see you next time.